Hello, ladies and gentlemen. How are we all doing today? Hope we're all good. Welcome back to Thornton Farmer. Today we're doing something a bit different. Got a phone call from the council this morning. They said, well, basically it snowed. And it's quite obvious, there's snow everywhere. It is winter now. A bit of snow fell, and for some reason the council has run out of salt already, even though it's very early in the winter. Apparently their salt delivery just hasn't arrived yet. So I've been out all morning. Whoa. And I've been sweeping up the roads and getting the snow off the roads for the council. You can see that what little salt was left after the previous night has done its work, but there are little snow drifts everywhere. So today we are going to be cleaning the roads up and just sweeping them off for the council so, well, cars can do their thing and drive around all nicely. Not the most exciting job in the world, I know, but it needs to be done. The council have basically said they'll renew the Stonehenge contract with us, which is great. Also, it turns out, I didn't know this, we've been scammed a small bit. Because the company that owns the compost master in that industrial estate, as well as pretty much everything else in that industrial estate, is called Thornton Farm Limited. We own that. I wasn't aware. We've got a bargain. So whoever told me that, you know, oh yeah, I own it, they were lying through their teeth. And trying to scam me out of what was effectively my money. Is that a field entrance? Yes. Oops, sorry, sir. Yes, I know this is inconvenient, but you'll have to deal with it. I'm busy. Shush. That's just a dirt path that doesn't need to be swept. The contract we have specifically states just paved roads, by the way. Now, if we can get this done in double quick time, which is difficult in the... well, it should be easy in the fast track in theory. In practice, not so much. This is a paved road over here. Yes, the council did say they have done the main roads. They also want me to clean out the local biogas plant. They do have a contract to deal with the biogas plant. Now, it looks like the biogas plant does have some of its own salt and did kind of make a path through, but not fully. Where is the entrance to the biogas plant? It's not over here by the looks of it. Also, I don't know why my GoPro keeps slipping and going into weird places. Okay, so it's not over there. So I need to do a quick spin around. Doesn't matter too much if I go on the grass, it's all frozen. It'll die anyway. Right. Let's get this thing up to speed. It is a fast track. We can go fast on the track. Turn on our indicator and head off to the right here. There we go. Right, here we go. Biogas plant. I said they want it mostly swept. Specifically the parking area here, so this isn't actually the biogas plant, but we'll do this for the owners of the grain stores as well. That guy must have parked there this morning because there's snow under the van. That ain't gonna melt anytime soon. There we go. This is when a yard tractor with a front linkage would be really useful, because I could use it for this job. However, we don't actually own one of those. So, we're going to have to make do with using and abusing the... oh my god, people, you have no patience. I think this place is actually owned by the biogas plant, so it shouldn't make too much of a difference if we sweep this place out. If anything, it'll get us potentially better prices when it comes to using to producing the grain that I plan on producing. There we go. Not the most exciting job in the world, I know, but it needs to be done. Sergei has been reveling in the snow. He's been making what I can only describe as, well, snow devils. By that I mean he's passed out multiple times already. It's only, what, 10 o'clock in the morning? He's already passed out about 6 times. He's got issues. I need to start sending him to meetings or something. But, yeah, he does the work and I don't really care after that. Is that all the snow? Oh, there's still a bit there. Let's grab this bit. There we go. And just grab these little bits in here as well. I do have this sweeper, by the way, treated so that it will just eat the snow. It's treated with salt, so it's just melting the snow immediately. And it's not going to produce ice. Because that's the last thing I want, is to just produce black ice in a car park. Or on country lanes. That's not a good thing to happen. Now, I know that I'm giving these cars little dings, but the sweeping brush I have is, it's got a very, very soft rubber bumper on the front, so it's not the biggest deal if I do ding a car a bit. It's just a case of, it'll provide a lot of resistance to me, but it'll do no damage to the car itself. There we go. Anything in there that needs to be swept? No. Let's get that bit. That new helper I was talking about, Trent or whatever his name was, I think somebody mentioned Quentin, that could be it. He'll be coming in the spring for his trial. We'll have him, hopefully if I can afford one, because I've been looking at the finances and they're not good at the moment. Hopefully we'll have him on a plow. Because I would like to get some of the fields plowed up and replanted in grass. Why is that so glitchy? Out of character, because I'm going to have to address this. My track hat's acting up today. I hope you noticed. Maybe it's, Oh. There's a cable in the way. I moved my microphone cable and that's interacting with the track hat, I think. That's interacting with the camera because there's, it's shiny. There we go. But Trent or whatever his name is, he will be arriving this spring. I am hoping, upon hope, that I'll be able to get a plow and hopefully a seeder. And we can get him out on a test drive. Kind of an audition, I guess. Why does this place have only vans from Wicklow in Ireland? That is indeed very odd. Does look like they want this place cleaned up as well. They did mention something to me about bales, so just gonna clean this area as well. Maybe it's that they want to buy the bales. I didn't think of that. Or they were looking for silage bales to buy to throw into their fermenter. They're willing to pay a pretty penny, actually. Also looking for somebody to take over the biogas plant. It's not been running the best. It'll take, they sent something in the region of £240,000 to get it back up and running at 100%. So that's a while off before we can even think of doing that. But hopefully in time we'll be able to basically buy the BGA here. And I know BGA is a German term. I think it stands for Biogasanlage or something. Yeah, I think it is Biogasanlage. But it's called a BGA here as well. I don't entirely know why. Because it's just a biogas plant. But maybe it's owned by the Biogas Association. That could be it. But I think there are still some laneways that need to be done. Don't hit the van too hard. There we go. They won't notice that dent. That'll buff out. That'll buff out. No problem at all. Now, I haven't forgotten about the church, by the way. The church does still need those trees pruned, and the winter is actually the perfect time to do it. Now, I have actually been in the forest, because part of my deal with the council is that we gain access to the forest. And we can do whatever we want down there. I've been getting the industrial estate up to full production, or as close to full production as I can. And the only thing that's not running at the moment is the compost master, because that's going to require some grass or something to actually get running. I missed a bit. There we go. So we're going to head back out onto the road now in a moment and see if we can't find any more paved laneways that need doing. But the industrial estate is now working at almost full production. There is a... Are we good to go here? I'm going to pull in for that guy, because I feel bad about getting in his way like that. Whoops. I'm gonna say that we're good to go because I can't see anything coming. Fantastic. Now, off again on the road to find a laneway like this one that requires a bit of sweeping. Now, this agreement is unpaid. I should mention that. We're not getting any profits from this. We are actually losing money because, you know, fuel costs. Alright, I'm back. Had to take a phone call from the council. They're pleased with what we're doing, by the way. They're pleased with the progress we've been making. And, do I need to go up there as well? Okay, so I have to make a U-turn at the end of this road. Let's just get this thing up to speed, and can't make a U-turn on the bridge, I know that much. That's the bridge I went over earlier on the main road, so I'm gonna have to... The sweeper is just a bit too wide for the bridge, so there's going to be a small bit of snow left over there, I think. And that's a dirt lane, that's fine. That is... Want to confirm a dirt lane? Yes. Just a reminder that we are only doing the paved roads. And, another bridge. This one we should be able to get over, no problem. And, wow, this... okay... This road got a bit of a going over, despite the hedges either side. Hedges ain't looking the best. Hedges ain't looking the best at the moment, because, well, winter takes its toll on everything, doesn't it? They're not evergreen hedges, they will lose their leaves in the winter. Not entirely sure where this road is even bringing me. But we're going to have to follow it until the end. We are making good progress through the snow, at least. And, we should be coming up to the end of this road soon. It kind of looks like this is the road that actually leads down from the farms. And if that's the case, I've swept up to the farms already. So I can use one of the yards as a U-turn area. If that's not the case, well, I'm kind of screwed. In fact, if it is the road up to the farm, and I think it is in fact, we can actually just continue on here and I'll pull a U-turn and go back, because otherwise I'll just be lost. But you can see that for the most part we do have these roads swept already. Does look like I've missed a bit down here. Oh, have I completely forgotten to sweep this road? I've complete Apparently, I went up from where exactly? I'm not sure where I am right now. Nothing new here, but I'm not entirely sure where I am. So what we're gonna have to do is basically just continue along the road for a bit longer and try and make a U-turn at the end of it, I guess. Possibly. Yeah, this is a complication I wasn't expecting. I have a feeling that's actually the lane way we're s No, that's a dirt lane. Interesting. And out of character real quick. Yes, I know there are frame rate issues. I don't know what's going on. I'll sort them later. I'm actually getting frame rate hitching on my end, so it's something's going a bit weird. Well, there's the main road ahead of us. There's the shop over to the l I know what I did wrong here. I started over by Stonehenge. I started the industrial estate because I came out of the shop with this thing. Did I come out of the shop with it or did I? No, I went up and I started over at the shop. And I can actually use that to U-turn. That's actually kind of convenient. Because I'm not entirely sure where that other laneway comes out. Actually, no, I'm going to turn right out of here and see if I can't link up with that other laneway on the way out. Because if I can get a link to the other laneway, that'd actually probably be the best thing to do. If I don't hit a hedge, that'd be even better. Sorry, sir, I know that I'm blocking your path, but I'm on official business. I'm busy. Right, let's try and find another laneway. There should be one around here somewhere, because I think all the laneways do link up together somehow. Is that it? That should be it. So this could well be the final laneway we need to sweep and to clean the snow off of. And if that's the case, that's great actually. You can see the grass poking through the snow. There wasn't much snow, so the grass is gonna poke through it, and so is the stubble. It wasn't quite enough to flatten the grass down, so it's enough to cause trouble, and that's really all the council cares about. And short of having their plow trucks out, which, they came down the main road, they gritted and plowed up the main road, they can't really fit the plow trucks down here, so. Did I somehow manage to miss all of this snow? Gonna reverse over this bit just to. Interesting. That snow is refusing to move. I guess I'll just have to let the council know, and I can't really do much else. I guess I could bring One of the, as it turns out, two wheel loaders I own down there. But this road, I happen to know, isn't very well used. And is that... No. Do you know what? That's Declan's house. He owns the other lawn mowing business in Thornton. That is Declan's house. Huh. Maybe I shouldn't have done this road then. Maybe I should have left this road be. But the simple fact that I'm doing his road should say something to Declan. That he needs to perk up his ideas, or else he'll be out of business. I did hear he... did a job recently at the church, and just... out of kindness, I'm going to clear out the churchyard here as well. As much as I can. Which apparently isn't much. Oh dear. But the more I can clean out, the better it's going to be for the church and the churchgoers. There we go. Nope, it's just not wanting to move. Okay. Guess the snow's a bit too tightly packed there, so let's... I guess realign ourselves on the road and get going again. Missed a bit. I figured we'd miss a bit doing that kind of shenanigans. There we go. It's gotta hurt Declan, really, seeing me going along doing what... Because I heard this used to be his job. And, he... I'm not entirely sure what happened, but he left for Sandy Bay or someplace like that. He's only recently returned. Please tell me this is actually the laneway that I intentionally skipped. That's a crossroads. This is the laneway I intentionally skipped, because this road is already done. Mostly. Yeah, this road's done already, so I must have come down here before. Which means if I follow this road along, I should hit the main road again. Reasonably quickly. Wonderful. Just pull straight out here. That should be all the laneways done. All the paved lane. Never mind. There's always one that just gets forgotten, isn't there? Let's see, did I miss much there? I missed enough that I'm not going to be happy with it. So let's just put the blinkers on here. There we go. Wonderful. That's much better. Much better indeed. Now, in theory, this is the last lane we will need to do. But I'm not 100% sure of the area quite yet, so I may still be wrong. May need to do a bit more. Is that another bridge? It's the edge of the council's area, so I don't care about roads beyond there. It's okay. There's a lovely place to do a 3-point turn right there. Magnificent. And off we go again down the road, looking for another laneway that I've probably missed. We can take a little bit of speed now, because there shouldn't be much left. In theory, at least. Plow trucks didn't do very well around here, did they? Yeah. I'm not going to do any extra, because I mean, I'm not even getting paid to do the laneways. I'm doing it to get a bit extra pull in the council chambers. Their laneway up this way. Swindon. Let's try over here. At the Stroud, Gloucester Road. No. Nothing up here, which is good. I'm gonna have to swing a super tight turn together though to didn't give myself anywhere near the space I need, and now there's a car behind me. This has all gone wrong. So, quick out of character moment here. I'm stuck against the edge of the map. I'm literally stuck between. Oh my god, please, please hit me. Please hit me. Please. You jerk. The one time I want the AI traffic to hit me. Come on. Hope this guy in the car doesn't move, because this is one of the most awkward turns I've ever pulled. I'm just shredding the engine, the tires, and this is not good for the tractor. Have you moved? No, you haven't. Okay, so we're now flat against the wall, which means we should be able to pull out of here. Wonderful. Oh. That almost ended with the police needing to be called. Let's head up the road to Coldborough Park here. And no, I don't see anything needing to be done up here. I'm just going to go out the road a small bit and see. But I don't... No, there's nothing here. I'll just pull into the... this yard here. And... Of course the traffic has decided to follow me along. Come on. Come on, off you go, come on. This is what you get for giving 90-year-olds driving licenses. Nothing coming up that way. Oh my god, you're going to have to... Never mind. Okay, you didn't have to wait. I thought you would have to. You'll have to wait for me, sir. The people around here need... All of them. Just every single person here needs their eyes checked. Do I want to clean out the Shell station? Nah. They make more than enough money. Right, let's... Actually, we need to go this way, because we've just come from the Sandy Bay Road. We are heading... towards Swindon is the direction we need to head, and I think John, just so Sergey gets better service, because he has been complaining about the service in here at the what was it, the Pern Inn or the Turn Inn? I bet it's called the Turn Inn. I'm going to, for free, without them asking, so I might get into trouble, sweep their yard here. The Pern Inn. Yeah, why is it called Pern Inn? I thought usually pubs had, like, punny names, and that's in no way a pun. Hope the owner doesn't mind, because this is... I didn't run this past him at all. I've just decided to randomly treat this yard. I mean, I'll give him a ring later on today, but it's It's 10 in the morning. I know that they run the pub by themselves and they don't exactly abide by normal opening hours. I think Sergei was in there until 4 o'clock one morning. They just do nightly lock-ins. They don't care, really. We should make Sergei happy at least, because he was complaining. Because it's not a couple of days ago. The council let it lie for a full day. He was complaining about the amount of snow in the yard, so it'll make Sergei happy at the very least. And probably the owners too, and Sergei might reap the benefits. Now I'm gonna leave a bit of a berth around their cars. That's Sergei's car. How did Sergei get home last night? I haven't seen Sergei yet today. I have a sneaking suspicion he got into the boot and fell asleep. Sergei has a habit of doing that. He did that in old streams a couple of times, and yeah. There have been a few times when I've been walking past his car for the boot to suddenly fly open and Sergei to jump out. Fresh as a daisy, mind you, but Oh god, that's his cousin Ivan's car. Oh dear. I have a feeling we won't be seeing Sergei for quite a while. Because, yes, he does drink a lot, but Ivan, yeah. Ivan takes it to a whole new level. I think that's where Sergei got the idea of sleeping in the boot, to be honest, because I know Ivan does. Sergei was telling me one day about how his cousin Ivan, you know, comes to visit from time to time. I didn't even know Ivan knew we were here yet. Sergei, you work quickly, sir. And so does Ivan, actually. I've only been here a few days. He's already come over and he's probably asleep. I'm so tempted to bump the back of the car. I'm so tempted. I'm gonna bump Sergei's car for sure. Wakey, wakey! That won't wake him up, but it makes me feel better, so. If it makes me feel better, it's the important thing, right? And quite honestly, those ladders, I've seen one get run over by a monster truck, and I'll put it this way, the monster truck was more damaged than the ladder. Never did see a wheel come off quite that violently before. Gonna leave Ivan alone, because he is not a very nice person. We'll just get this bit. And Sergei's gonna wonder what happened to the yard when he wakes up, and why his ladder now has a small little insignificant dent, but he will notice it. And he will blame me, and he will be correct. I'm just gonna sweep up the entryway a bit more. I do believe I've got stuck. No, that's fine. That'll do. I can't do much better. And we started off down there, which means we can finish down here. Because I do believe this is the... No, this is not the way down to the farm. I've been down this road already. I am an idiot. Farm is much further down this road, I believe. I think. I may or may not be lost. If we get to the shop... Oh, there's the shop, so the farm is... there it is. Wonderful. So we don't want to take this turn off. This will take us down to the farm as well. That's the back way in. Oh, that's where we were. That's where we were when I got confused. We were at the back entrance of the farm. Dalton stores don't actually want us to sweep for them. But... Stonehenge still needs a bit of sweeping. I'm pretty sure this falls under the council. What on earth? I'm guessing somebody tried to... Somebody obviously tried to plow the area and they didn't know what they were doing. So they've just... they've just made giant snow drifts. Oh, that car is not getting out until this snow melts. That car's stuck. Nah, the micro might get out. But... what is that thing? Is that a Mark 1 Escort? Whatever it is, it's pretty. And, more big snowdrifts. We did, by the way, accidentally leave all of our equipment down here. The council didn't mind. As it turns out, all the cars that are usually here are usually abandoned. So the council didn't particularly care all that much. We have, however, just got the brush stuck. Oh, what on earth is this? Yeah, that's properly stuck, isn't it? Can I at least push it forward? Oh, okay. Now I've got the fast track stuck. I'm just making things work worse for myself. I may need professional help here. Yeah, I'm gonna have to abandon this. And, yeah. I'm gonna have to call a recovery service and walk back to the farm, I think. It's not too far a walk. But, yeah, on that note, I'll leave you guys by saying I've been Rainbow Davey, you've been watching Farming Simulator 17 on Thornton Farm. Hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, hit the like button below and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. Until next time, stay safe and goodbye.